The iPhone XR, a phone which has started a lot of fights online. Apple fans saying that it is good enough to carry the hefty price tag, Apple haters calling it a ripoff for what it offers. Apple did try to make a cheaper iPhone once with the 5C, but we all know how that went. On paper though, it seems like Apple has learned from their mistakes. Going into this open-minded, there's actually a bit of truth on both sides, but most importantly, this feels like an iPhone Steve Jobs would have approved to be released. It has the same processor as the more expensive models, same Face ID, and the same main camera. There is only one area of concern: the display. There is actually a lot of misleading information online, so if you can and if you're interested in the iPhone XR, I would just go down to a store to see one for yourself. The thing is, yes, the pixel density, meaning how many pixels can fit side by side into 1 inch, is unchanged from the days of the iPhone 4. Sounds bad, but remember what was said on stage back then? The pixel density of 326 ppi was specifically chosen because the human eye struggles to see the difference if the ppi increases any further. So why bother? The problem was that many competitors started releasing high resolution panels on their flagship phones, and it started to seem like Apple was lagging behind. So to keep up, the larger plus-sized iPhones got a bump up to 401 ppi. To make matters even more complicated, the iPhone X, XS and XS Max got a bump up yet again. This is not because Apple has changed their mind on how they choose resolution for their panels, but it is determined by the fundamentals of how the panel is designed and constructed. All iPhones up until the X were using LCD displays. This means that every pixel, the little square which makes up an image, consists of three subpixels: red, green and blue. The mixture of which can create pretty much any color from black, meaning all off, to pure white, all on. The X switched to an Oled display. These have been available on Android phones for a while, but up until recently were limited by some shortcomings. Though still not totally eliminated, the situation these days is much better, and they also bring very attractive positive points, like better contrast and lower power consumption. The key is that, in simple terms, unlike an LCD, each little pixel consists of only two subpixels, using the neighboring ones to trick your brain into perceiving colors as you are used to. Hence, one could say that the effective pixel density of an OLED display is a third lower compared to an LCD. Using the numbers from the iPhone XS spec sheet, 458 pixels per inch, subtracting a third, we get 305 ppi. So pretty much the same as the iPhone XR. Not to mention, the XR doesn't use just any LCD, but one which supports wide color gamut, gets very bright at 625 nits, is amazingly color accurate, and can adapt to environment conditions. On top of all of this, LCDs generally have a longer lifespan than OLEDs, because in OLEDs, the blue subpixels age quicker than the other colors. Not a problem with LCDs, given they use conventional white LEDs as a backlight. And when the time comes to replace the display, either because of age or you simply just drop the phone, the LCD will be much cheaper. Just look at the official Apple repair pricing to replace a screen. $199 for the XR versus $279 for the XS and $329 for the XS Max. So that's about it from my side. I will leave some more links in the video description going into more details on the topic if you're interested. But for now, see you in the next one.